Good morning! Good morning! Today, it's 7 a.m. That's why I'm about 3 out of 10 on energy. But I've got my 110F2, that's the size of my head. Because we're taking a portrait of a personal trainer who's a boxing trainer. There you go, language. He's a boxing trainer and a stand-up comedian. His name's Sergio. I've been working with him for a while. He's a lovely, lovely, lovely man. And he wants some portfolio stuff done to make his business work. Now, this is my first GFX session. We're going to be shooting at Overthrow in London, which is a really cool boxing gym. I'm making coffee, but I'm not going to make coffee like a fucking B-roll. I make coffee because I need it for life and energy and stuff. Don't put healthy suggestions of lifestyles in the comments. It's not that I don't care about my health. It's just that, you know, I don't care about my health. Oh, we're super low energy this morning, but we're going to have to improve that. Now, the thing about Overthrow is it's quite a low light place. It's an overcast day in New York City. Ooh. So it's an overcast day. So we're going to have to try and work out some interesting light situations. Sergio is a really cool guy. I'm looking forward to shooting with him. But yeah, the situation is either going to be dark for the neon lights, which is, oh, it looks cool, man. It's hard to make that look cool. But we're going to be testing the low light performance of this. I think I might need to lean quite heavily on ISO today. So we might be able to do some interesting tests around ISO performance. It's an F2 lens, but what I found in my very limited experience of using this camera is it ain't like, it doesn't go where the X-T4 goes. They're not like the same camera.
Oh, obviously, Charlie, this is a medium format camera.
Yes, I know, but I'm learning as well. I'm learning as well. I've never owned a medium format camera. Anyway, I'm making my coffee. This is going to make some noise, but I'll play some music over it. If you like coffee B-roll, then I will make coffee B-roll. But I don't really want to, because it's not really my, I just want to drink coffee. Like that, all that. It's just, who are you kidding? Who are you kidding, filmmakers? Who are you kidding?
Welcome to Soho. We're going to East Village. Oh, pick up your fucking dog mess. How you doing?
What's going on, man?
Oh, making a video.
All right, Mr. DeMille, I'm ready for my close-up.
How'd that feel?
That felt great. I felt natural, I felt comfortable, and I feel like, you know, fresh and strong. I can't wait to look at the free pictures
I'm getting. No, they're not free. They're super expensive. It's a highly premium service. Thanks, Sergio. So let's talk about the camera. That was a really challenging light situation. We had a lot of colors in it. We had a lot of things flying off the sensor. I didn't use my light meter. I probably should have there, because it was a little bit thing, but I was mainly concerned about sharpness and making sure, because I think I've got so much flexibility in the image afterwards, there's a lot I can do. Thinking about posing, thinking about working with the models, you can always get so much better at that. But the camera itself handled pretty damn fabulously. I'm very happy with it. It's not a rapid shooter, you're being intentional, you're really slowing down your workflow, which is good. I think we could all use that rather than coming back with 500 shots, and come back with 50.
This is my 32-64 lens, by the way. Hi. So I took some shots on this, but I actually had a chance to use my portrait lens, which is sitting in my bag. You've seen it before. It's the big boy. Love that lens. We've got some images to look at. But first, so I was fascinated by ISO performance. It's not going to get technical, so not technical. But I was, on my X-T4, I'm shooting at 100 ISO, maybe 200, 300, 400 if I'm feeling particularly spicy. I'm big on preserving those ISO values because I don't want noise in my photos. This guy, with my higher apertures and low light performance, needs to rely on it a little bit heavily. So let's get into the images. The images. in the arches.
26 pictures, and we've been sat here for 8 minutes. It's but 26 pictures is what? It's like 10 gig. This is mad. I have a top spec Mac. In fact, what is the spec of my MacBook? I have 32 gigs of RAM and a quad core whatever.
I can't take it anymore! I just want to die!
Look at this! Straight off the bat, how many images have we got? 21 images. Say a shout out to the UK garage crew. There's no one. That's no one. If you are, hi. Ugh. Again, these are straight out of camera. I don't think it's helpful if I'm like, oh, and I've added all my edits, and look at how, you know, I've made all my blacks super thick and whatever else like this. This is what you're getting out of the camera, okay? So if you're thinking about buying this thing, if you pointed at stuff, this is what might happen. This is great. I love the colors in this shot. Hello. Look at his little happy little face. Again, look at this. He's got nice teeth. That's a great shot. I'm super, 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 super happy with that one. Okay, again, I haven't touched a thing on any of these. So these are, you couldn't ask for a better location than the boxing center. It just looks so good. Again, it's a bit moody there. You don't want to fight him. That's pretty badass there. But again, I don't really want this fridge in there. So that's one of the benefits of medium format is you can really play around with the crops. And again, you've taken the fridge out. God, I'm good at this. He's got the veins on his arms popping through. How's his tattoo resolution? Pretty damn fly. Oh, so good. Again, I'm liking the colors and the lights and things are going to be super interesting with this. Again, as a framing, this is lousy. I switched to the 32mm lens here, but let's just look at some of the options that you've got to crop here. Ridiculous. Ridiculous. I want to steal this bag in there. I'm going to put his eyes on this line here. Ah! I now have a usable image. A usable image. He's looking strong. He's looking powerful. Again, like this. That pisses me off. That's straight out of the schoolboy. Jesus, the detail, though. That's the schoolboy era. You've cut off his toes. It's a weak image, but part of the benefits of having 102 megapixels is I can find pictures within pictures. Let's try and line up this as a faux frame. And again, look, usable images. I'm gonna bring that in a little bit more. I can make it really tight on the bag, and look at this. Again, I have so much options with this image. I can do so much with it. I'm gonna keep these frames. This is such a cool location. I don't like the wires, but again, you can see what I'm doing here. Look at the size of the image that I've got to work with, and look how much optionality I can get out of this thing in terms of resolution and play. It's awesome. Again, just even getting, because quite often, you know, customers want things for their social media, so they just want little quirky little vibes, and boom. I mean, this, the resolution. Look at this. This is why you're buying medium format. This is why you're, again, there's some neon in the background. I knew that'd be annoying. I'm gonna double expose it, take the highlights out. And yeah, we've got some details back, all right. There's a ton more that you can do to this. And again, these are totally unedited. That is the only edit I've done, is bringing the highlights down. I'll put them back up in case people go, meh. It's just a bit shit, so I'm just gonna press delete on that one. Again, great colors, great images. And you took one of me. He took one of me, which I already edited for Instagram to make it a little bit moodier, which is much more my aesthetic. I'm gonna halt the video here, guys, only because I can't be bothered to show you my edit process. I think that's my pick of the images. Absolutely great, great face, what approachable. Like, oh, so tack sharp. Love it. He shaved his head as well. I told him that I'd be able to tell. It's a great image there. Some of the colors and the resolution on this is just insane. Absolutely insane. Love it. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll be back when I'm back.